So please welcome Kyle Johnson.
Well, thank you, Pete. Who, just so you guys know, been my best friend forever. And I wouldn't be the person I am today without her. Now, a little. I would like to start by taking a trip down memory lane, so to speak, and begin by saying that if you really knew me, you know that I'm a Darby. Along with several of you, I started here at Darlington in kindergarten 13 years ago. I turned 18 next week, and of my 18 years, almost 13 have been spent at Darlington, so this is in many ways my family. I can remember visiting Glory School just after my fifth birthday on what I think they used to call Super Saturday. I remember telling my dad how much I loved it and asking if I could go there. Time has really flown by, hasn't it? I would like for you to indulge me and raise your hands if you can remember any of the following memories. The Purple Playground. Bringing frogs to school the first day of first grade. Cole Miller getting married in Miss Cox's kindergarten. Yeah, I played Elvis in that, the same, one of my finer moments. And Witch's Brew song. The Halloween parade through the gym and around the lower school track. Your parents purchasing 20 magazine subscriptions so that you could race a stuffed mechanical pig in the gym. Mrs. Summerman. Mrs. Bradshaw, the mad scientist. Miss Ripple. We've all come a long way, and I for one am both glad and sad to see him here. As I said before, 13 of my 18 years have been spent here in Darlington. If you really knew me, you know the most important thing in the world to me is my faith in God. I am Roman Catholic. And as a side note, most of us don't have 19 children, although I know one man who has two of them. We don't worship the Virgin Mary. And my family personally doesn't eat fish on Fridays because my little brother doesn't really care for fish. If you really know me, you know that I have three siblings here at Darlington and three that are in heaven. I have my sister O'Keefe, grade 11. Abraham, and grade 9. And Mamie, grade 7. Those three sisters of mine that are in heaven are Sarah, Lauren, and Abigail. And I'm sure they're watching right now and they're smiling. And also over the years, we've had about 10 dogs, a late lizard last week, a salamander, a newt, countless fish, several hermit crabs, 7 horses, and because of a lot of switch offs and problems, we now only have one. This is my family. If you really knew me, you know that I love nature, the outdoors, animals, and I'm proud to say it, Boy Scouts. I've just made Eagle Scout last week and worked this past summer teaching environmental science at Camp Jenny. And apparently it's the best teacher I've had in 17 years in that area. But I also love music, though I must admit the music, most of the music I love is from the 70s, 80s, and 90s. Although that's not to say that there's been some music in the early 21st century that I really loved. If you really knew me, you'd know that I hate injustice. I can't stand it when bad things happen to good innocent people. I can't even sit through a movie that has that, like, anger management. Good angle. If you really knew me, you know that I love learning. I love to read. I especially love to write, as John said, and write a book. And I've written that novel and I'm writing a second one. And you tend to write anymore. That's not great. Now please raise your hand if you've ever, this is more likely to happen in middle school, wanted to strangle me for going on and on about my book. Thank you for being honest. That's funny. Yeah. You know, I really loved lower school. I was so excited to come to the old middle school. Sixth grade was great. But then there was seventh and eighth grade. And they weren't so great. I became the subject of bullying. Being touched only by boys and girls in the class. And I was told at the time that it would get better in lower school. And it did. But there are wounds suffered that I'll probably always have scars from. I was probably possibly annoying, but I did not deserve the treatment I received. As I got into upper school, most of the bullying ceased, with the exception of an occasional problem now and then. And from that, I've learned it was pretty funny that people can mature a lot in that one a year, ninth grade, talking to freshmen. If you really knew me, and this is kind of ironic because this is ADHD, we're going to speak. I was born with a deficit of serotonin in my brain. That serotonin, not dopamine, for the AP psychology class. But it left me with a condition called attention deficit disorder and hypersensitivity, not hyperactivity. I know that many of you suffer with ADHD as well, but I might just have to begin my conditions today. When I was in first grade, my teacher, Ms. Starnes, she called my parents and suggested they consult a doctor, because apparently in 40 years of teaching, she had never met a child so uncomfortable in their own body. That's me. I have very poor motor skills. Simple things like shooting basketball, throwing certain sun balls, and even running or dancing can be very uncomfortable for me, because I'm really uncoordinated. Many of you may remember that I used to have this odd bouncing gait, like walking up my tiptoes. And first grade, it took a while to get over that. It took almost 2 years to retrain my mind and body to walk in a more normal fashion. I've heard some people, even teachers, say that ADHD is just a kid not trying hard enough, or being lazy, or the parents are just lazy. That's crap. I want you to know what ADD is like for me. If you can imagine sitting in a small room, just close your eyes, sitting in a small room with six screaming, crying babies, along with six laughing, giggling 5-year-olds. And in the corner, there's an old man using a chainsaw, and in the other, another guy hammering nails into wood. And while this is going on, a bird, or maybe a flock of birds, just flying around your head singing. Across the room is your teacher, friend, or stranger, trying to tell you your teacher is being very important. Does this sound like it needs to concentrate? Believe me, this is one. And you might think, well, that's an exaggerated example, but it really isn't. I hear every cough, scratch, pencil tapping, toe tapping, steps out in the hallway, all that. Close to think of. And you could actually say that ADD is more of a hearing problem for me. I hear too much. I tell about my ADD because it is such a part of my life. But there's a little more to the story. Two more parts of the story. My ADD caused me to have a deficit of social filters and social skills. A delay, not like I don't have them. But, you have to ask yourself, was it me? I don't read nonverbal cues very well. I can come across rather rude sometimes. I can be telling someone about something I find fascinating. Not pick on the fact that they aren't interested, or at least not as much as me. And I often say things impulsively without realizing that I'm being rude. I don't have the means of monitoring myself that other people have and take for granted. It really sucks not to have them. Just saying. A good friend asked me this weekend, senior retreat, if I ever thought before I spoke. And the answer is no. I try, but oftentimes I have put a little filter. My real response to him, however, was, do you ever think before you vote? He and I were friends, don't see eye to eye. I take prescribed medication for my ADD, and it does help some. But unfortunately, it stops working about 3 o'clock each day. So this leaves me on my own for homework, test, preparation, and projects. Needless to say, it's been difficult at times. Yes, it's been a time of anguish and magic at Darlington, as Darlington is a very different place. Finally, if you really knew me, you know that I am hypersensitive, or very passionate. That is, when I'm happy, I'm really happy. What you see as sad, I see as tragic. When I'm frustrated or angry, I'm really frustrated or angry. And basically what I'm trying to say is my emotions are heightened. Not fake, but heightened. I feel them more deeply, just like my sensory processes. Now, I think you guys know me a little better, even though many of you have known me for years. I'm your friend, or at least I've always been to be. And I am a really good friend, but very little. And if you really knew me, you know that I cherish my friendships. I want to be your friend in these remaining months here in Arlington. In closing, I'd like you to think of remember. Seniors, you've only got about a squint left, right? Juniors, you only have about 18 months. Enjoy what you have. Take advantage of the opportunities. Open up to people that are different. Give them a break. And so, with that, I'd like to leave you with two quotes. First is, my best friend, always been there for me, my sandals, Dr. Laurie Johnson. Something she taught us when me and my siblings were little. Difference, not bad. Difference, just different. And secondly, Thomas Wolfe wrote, man's youth is a wonderful thing. It is so full of anguish and magic. And he never knows it. He never comes to know it as it is until it is gone from him forever. So, class of 2012, carpe diem, seize the day. Thank you.